Welcome, I'm Jenna Garrido.
And I'm Richard Foster. Winter sports is just around the corner. We've got the first game schedules for you.
And we've got money-making opportunities just for you, but only if you're the fastest in the school at solving this 40-year-old 3D puzzle.
So put your puzzle-solving hats on.
It's time for TBN Student News. Called the Mayflower Challenge, a number of Putnam students took part in this event a week ago this past Monday. Volunteers collected food in the Springfield to help fill the shelves of the open pantry. The organization helps feed our city's hungry. It's a big job, especially during the winter. The event was sponsored by radio personalities Baxton O'Brien's. We salute all the students who took part.
The Mayflower's Challenge is an important challenge. It feeds the homeless and people in need throughout the winter. This year, again, they set a new record. I was told they raised over $125,000 worth of food for the cause.
So, Richard, if you had the choice, would you rather be the smartest kid in the school or the most popular?
Why do you ask?
Because that's the topic of this week's Either Or segment.
Would you rather be the smart kid in school or the popular kid in school?
The smart kid, because if you're popular, you can't get nowhere in life, and if you're smart, you can get somewhere in life.
Smart kid, because it opens more doors, like more opportunities, so I can get more stuff to help my education.
I'd rather be the smart kid because, you know, smart kids are really cool, man, and they're the popular ones.
I'm the smart kid because, like, you get better things out in life, and then you be the cool kid and you might not get nothing in life.
I'd rather be the smart kid in school because popularity doesn't get you anywhere.
I'd rather be the smart kid because intelligence is key.
Smart kid because education comes first.
The smartest kid in school because the smarter you are, the more money you make.
You didn't answer my question.
You mean, would I rather be smart or popular?
That's right.
That's a hard one because, as you know, I'm both.
At least you're not humble. And to tell you the truth, neither of these two next guys. But they are good at what they do. Time for sports, here's world-class wrestler Davin Peterson and the best of the ballers, Jalen Bruce.
What's up, guys? I hope y'all had an awesome vacation. I know me and my bro Jalen did, right, bro?
Yeah, bro. I ate all that Thanksgiving food. I had a curry goat white rice. Oh, my goodness.
Bro, I had that soul food with the sweet potato and the collard greens.
Man, you want to smack your mama?
Mm-hmm. All right, let's go into the wrestling news. The boys are working really hard in practice to win a Western Mass Championship this season. Last season, we took second. Now we're going for first place as a team. Me and my teammates are determined to win it all. Our first tournament is on the 10th of December, and we're hosting it at SciTech at 10 o'clock. Hope to see y'all in the bleachers supporting.
Now it's time for the best sport ever. We playing basketball.
Bro.
What?
That's boring.
What, brother? You must be crazy, man.
Man, I'm just joking.
Better be, but me and my teammates are looking so good to win our fifth Western Mass Championship in a row. We've been working hard in the court. Our first game is the 17th of December at Mass Mutual Center at 9:30 p.m. against Narragansett High School. But Davin here had a chance to interview one of the varsity players, sophomore, Nashawn Jernigan. Let's get that chicken.
So Nashawn, how do you feel as the season gonna go this year?
I feel the season gonna go good, not too bad.
What do you have to do to get another championship?
Just play defense and listen to what our coaches have to say and we'll be good.
How do you feel about your coaches?
They're good. They can let us to a four, so they can lead us to a fifth.
What is their philosophy in coaching?
He just wants us to play a lot of defense and communicate, pretty much.
Time for the girls' turn in basketball. These girls want to have another season of being undefeated, and this year they will win Western Mass. Last year they lost Western Mass, but this year they're going for first place. And their first game is December 14th against Monument Mountain at 7 p.m. But Jalen had an interview with junior Keandra Goldsberry. Let's take a look at that interview.
It was a good one.
So how do you think the season's going to go this year?
I think the season's going to go good. I think we're going to be undefeated.
I heard you got a new coach. How you feel about it?
I feel good about it. I think we're going to strive for better things this year.
Have your coach ever talked to you guys?
Yeah, she did.
What did she say?
She asked us what was our personal goals and what was our team goals. And then she told us more about how she used to play basketball and, you know, let us know.
So what's your team goal?
Our team goal is to make it all the way.
You think your coach can help you get that goal?
Of course.
time for the race for the first place in indoor track like Usain Bolt. The boys and girls are working really hard to win Western Mass as a team and get first place. Their first meet is against East Longmeadow at 6:45 p.m. at Smith College on the 7th of December.
All right, but that's a wrap for this week in sports. From your favorite wrestler, Davin Peterson.
And your favorite basketball player, Jalen Bruce. Have a nice weekend.
See ya.
Didn't want to be ya.
It's kind of weird not having any games or matches or meets going on.
You're right, and I hate weird.
Well, there's nothing weird about the next story. It's about a Putnam freshman, a 3D puzzle, and just maybe the fastest hands in the business. In this edition of I've Got Talent, reporter Wesley Rivera tracks down a young man who makes a Rubik's Cube look easy.
Hi, I'm Wesley Rivera, and welcome to I've Got Talent. Today we're going to meet up with freshman William McClary to see his skills with the Rubik's Cube. William got interested in the Rubik's Cube about 6 months ago in his middle school.
My friend did it back in STEM. He had a Rubik's brand, did it, and I'm just like, you know what, I want to do that, because something to do with your hands. And I just learned over a while, just stuck.
He says doing the Rubik's Cube is a tricky mind game that requires a lot of thinking.
It's algorithms, which is just a series of moves to do something. Like, let's say I'm on the cube and I'm just trying to put this edge is here and I'm trying to put it here. I just do the series of moves, which is like that series of moves to put that edge there.
The Rubik's Cube is also helpful for him when he has nothing to do.
It's just something to do with my mind. Like, I'm very fidgety. Like, this is something I can do with my hands. And I have a bad memory, and this helps my memory at the same time.
It's hard to believe that he started 6 months ago. Now he's really good.
It's just practice repetition, that's all. Doing it and looking at orientations, that's it.
We timed him on how fast he could do the 3x3 cube, and the results were impressive. If you think you're faster than William McClary, stay tuned because we have news for you. And there you have it, William McClary, the Rubik's Cube Master. I'm Wesley Rivera, reporter for TBN News. Back to you guys.
Wow, that's fast, but is it the fastest? TBN is sponsoring a Rubik's Cube contest for Putnam students. All you have to do is stop in our studio and show us how fast you can solve a 3x3 Rubik's Cube. We'll take the two fastest times and have those students face off for the championship. And here's the good part. The winner gets $100. You have until December 16th to enter the contest.
So start practicing, and when you're ready, come see us in our multimedia shop.
Skills USA is asking you to join their program called Season for Giving Care Baskets to the Homeless. Skills is asking you to bring donations to your shop. They want personal care items like toothpaste, toothbrushes, mouthwash, dental floss, bars of soap, shampoo, and other items. Please bring to your shop before Friday, December 23rd. The shop with the most donations will receive a donut breakfast when we return from winter break. Ms. Smith is the subject of this week's High Profile.
Ms. Smith has been at Putnam for 15 years.
I love my job because it's different daily. Sometimes I could be helping students with a resume. Sometimes I'm helping students pick a book out. Sometimes I'm doing collection development.
But she's always teaching and helping students with their work or research.
Research is more than just doing a Google search. There are specific parts to the research process, and I could share that with them, and I have in the past.
Ms. Smith has spent countless hours creating an environment that inspires learning.
It's a beautiful space. It's your library, not mine. I want you guys to enjoy it. Even if you don't read books, it's still nice to come in here and sit down and relax. We have magazines and puzzles and Scrabble and things for you to do that are not related to books, although my passion is to get you into a book.
We live in the digital age, but Ms. Smith believes nothing will replace the paperback.
We have e-books. The kids know, students know that we have e-books. They don't like e-books. They like to have the book in their hand. Some of them do read online. Some of them will read an e-book. But most of the time, they want the book in a hardcover. So I think there's a balance. I think for me, I read on an e-book, and I also read regular books. So, and I think that's the same with the students that are readers and are always going to be readers for life. Are going to be the same way.
And for her, it's all about reading.
One of my best things is having you guys ask me for a book, and I have it, and I can give it to you.
This is Jason Yevis for TBN News signing off.
You've heard the term, the oldest line in the book. Well, how about the corniest pickup line in the book? In this week's candid question, I asked Putnam students, what was the corniest pickup line they ever heard?
What's the corniest pickup line you ever heard?
Are you from Tennessee? Because you're the only town I see.
If I could redo the alphabet, I'd put you and I together.
Did it hurt?
Did what hurt?
When you fall from heaven.
What's the corniest pickup line you ever heard? You
ready for this one?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Does your name start with a C?
No, it doesn't.
Because I could see us together.
I'm about to say your man's girl.
If you are a lollipop, I'll lick you.
Thanks for joining us on TBN Student News. See you next time.